to Allah, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon His final messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. May Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, his righteous companions, and his followers until the day of judgment. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we'd like to welcome you again to this live broadcast of the Fajr and Eid prayers here from the Prophet's Mosque in Holy Medina. We have just finished the Fajr prayer here in the Prophet's Mosque in Holy Medina, and now we are waiting eagerly to pray the Eid prayers, inshallah ta'ala, and also listen to the Eid sermon, which will be made by Sheikh al-Imam Dr. Hussein al-Sheikh. May Allah reward him. Allahumma ameen. We are in a great day, this Holy Eid, the second Eid in the year, which is Eidul Adha, which marks the symbolic event that took place on this day by our father, the father of all the prophets, Ibrahim, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, when he was ordered by his God, when he was ordered by Allah the Almighty, the All-Knowing, for a wisdom that Allah only knows, to sacrifice his son Ismail, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him. And he honestly and sincerely did so. And then at the final moments and before the sacrifice took place, Allah the Almighty, also for a wisdom that he only knows, has replaced Ismail, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, with an animal from paradise. This great lesson for us Muslims on this day, the day of Eidul Adha, is that we shall obey the commands of Allah, no matter what we are commanded to do, no matter what we are told to do by Allah the Almighty and by our beloved Messenger Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him. Allahumma ameen. This is what a Muslim should be. This is the belief and the sincerity that Muslims should hold in their hearts and shall be reflected in their actions and their acts of worship that they do for Allah. That no matter what the command is, no matter what the occasion is, we shall obey Allah fully and obey Him to our hardest and to our fullest. And we shall always aim and aspire to please Him. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we said before the Adhan, today's sermon will be delivered by Sheikh al-Imam Dr. Hussein al-Sheikh, as we were notified by this earlier today. And as we said, it will cover the importance and significance of this day of Eidul Adha, and the benefits of this day and the great merits of it, as well documented in the noble Quran and also in the traditions of the Prophet of Allah, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, and in his sayings and his actions, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, his family members and his righteous companions until the day of judgment. Allahumma ameen. So as we said, we will listen to this sermon, which will cover the importance and significance of this day, and then the Sheikh will touch upon the critical issues that our nation faces these days, and also will remind us of the importance of unity for us Muslims, and also what acts of worship shall be done on this day, and what to do and what not to do in this day, the day of Al-Eid. So Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah, we praise Him for the arrival of this day. We express our gratitude, our happiness, our praise towards Allah for extending in our lives so that we could live till this day, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah. Also, today marks the last day of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. These best 10 days of the year have arrived to their climax, have approached their end, just like any other season of worship that we see and witness in this life. It starts and then it comes to end, to an end, just like everything in life. Yet we praise Allah, and also we thank Allah, and we ask Him to accept from us, and we ask Him to extend our lives so that we could live to many, many Eids to come, inshallah ta'ala. And also we ask Him to shower His blessings upon those who died before the arrival of this Eid. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us also not forget our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters who are now in Mina undertaking the rituals of the great pillar of Islam, the pillar of the pilgrimage to Mecca and to the Holy Lands. They still have 2 or 3 days left in their Hajj, so we ask Allah to make this easy to them and to make the reminder of their journey, their blessed journey, an easy task for them, and to accept from them Allahumma ameen. The great thing about supplication, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, besides being the brain of worship, as said by the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, is that when the Muslim supplicates for his fellow Muslim brothers and sisters in Islam, the angels would reply, Ameen, and to you would be the same. Wa ameen wa laka bi mithl. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us not forget our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters who are now carrying out the rituals of the great pilgrimage to Mecca. And also, let us not forget our Muslim brothers and sisters all around the globe by praying to Allah to ease their difficulties and hardships and to grant them victory that He has promised them. Allahumma ameen. Also, we ask Allah to greatly reward the government of this country, the government of the custodian of the two holy mosques, for the great efforts that they do in servicing the holy lands and servicing the Prophet's mosque here in Holy Medina and servicing the Grand Mosque in Mecca as well. Here from where the calls to the prayers are made, here from this part of the Prophet's mosque, I could see the callers to the prayer have all gathered here waiting eagerly for the commencement of the takbir that precedes the Eid prayer, which is the loud repetition, out loud repetition of the remembrance of Allah and of saying Allah is great, praise be to Allah, and there is no God worthy for Him but Allah. We'll be listening to this and we will be with you live with the crew members of the Saudi Channel 2 and the Sunan Abuya Channel, may Allah reward them, Allahumma ameen. We'll all be with you live for the coverage and for the live broadcast of this great day, the great day of Eidul Adha. Not only this, but we will also be with you in yet another live broadcast right after the sermon, where we will provide you with a brief translation of the sermon and also with a summary and briefing of the key points and the key messages that were mentioned in the sermon, which will be delivered, as we said earlier, by Sheikh al-Imam Dr. Hussein al-Sheikh. May Allah reward him. Allahumma ameen. Today is a happy day, so let us all express our happiness. Today is a great day, so let us all praise Allah for the arrival of this day, and we are alive and capable of worshipping Allah in it. Today is a holy and most blessed day, so let us also have blessings within blessings. Let us also share the blessings between us Muslims. Let us not forget our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters from the visits, from the giving of the sacrifice, from the giving of the parts of the sacrifice to the poor and needy Muslims, as a way and as a symbol of collaboration between us Muslims and as a symbol of feeling for each other, as this is one of the main and major qualities for us Muslims, that we feel for one another, that we respect one another, inshallah ta'ala. So the callers to the prayer are making themselves ready to start the out loud repetition of the remembrance to Allah, of the sayings that say Allahu Akbar, Allah is great, La ilaha illallah, there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, and also by saying Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd, Allah is great, and praise be to Allah. This will be repeated out loud in a beautiful fashion, in a wonderful and gorgeous fashion, as is the tradition before the Eid prayer. This will be repeated for about a few minutes before the arrival of the Imam, who will then lead us in the prayer before Allah for two rakas, the two rakas of the Eid al-Fitr, of the Eid al-Adha, and then we will listen to the sermon, inshallah ta'ala. So the callers to the prayer, the Muaddineen of the Prophet's Mosque, are making themselves ready, and we at the Saudi Channel 2 have the great pleasure to be with you in this live broadcast and to cover this live here from the Prophet's Mosque, here from this great place, here from the place that's only feet away. That's only feet away from the chamber of Aisha bint Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the mother of the believers, were the body of our great prophet, of our beloved messenger Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, and the bodies of his two noble companions, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Umar bin al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with them, all are buried here in the chamber of Aisha bint Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the mother of the believers, are only feet away from this and feet away from al-Baqiyah, the graveyard of the inhabitants of al-Madinah al-Munawwara, of the inhabitants of the enlightened city, where at least 10,000 of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, are buried. So all praise is indeed due to Allah. We praise him, we seek refuge in him. We seek refuge in him from the evils of our souls and from the evils of our bad deeds. He whom Allah guides, no one can misguide him, and he whom Allah misguides, no one can guide him. We praise Allah, we praise him for his endless blessings and bounties upon us Muslims. We praise him for making us Muslims. We praise him for making us members of this nation, the Muhammadi nation, al-Ummat al-Muhammadiyya, for making us members of this nation that accounts for the majority of the inhabitants of the gardens of paradise. May Allah make me and you and our parents amongst them. Allahumma ameen. May Allah accept from us. May Allah extend our lives so that we witness more happy occasions, more Eids, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah make this day a happy day and a victorious day for our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters all around the globe. May Allah extend in our lives so that we see victory is brought to all Muslims all around the globe. May Allah extend our lives so we see this beautiful religion, this beautiful faith, this beautiful religion, the religion of Islam, is expanding everywhere. And this true message, the message of the unity of Allah, the message that the Prophet of Allah, may Allah's peace and blessings be unto him, is his final messenger. This message, may Allah extend our lives so we see it expanded and believed in. Allahumma ameen. May Allah accept from us all. May Allah make this day a happy day for us, a blessed day for us. May Allah also make it a happy day for the guests of the merciful, for our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters who are now carrying out the rituals of the month, in the month of Dhul Hijjah, the rituals of the great pillar of Islam, the pillar of pilgrimage, this fifth pillar of Islam. These days that we live in, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, are great days, are holy days, are days that comprise more than one act of worship, and each act of worship is a great act in itself. From fasting yesterday, the day of Arafah, until today, which is the day of Eid, in which fasting is prohibited, yet it is full of the remembrance of Allah, of showing gratitude and praise to him, to the carrying out of pilgrimage, which is also carried out by millions of believers, millions of Muslims right now in Mecca and in the holy lands in Mecca, Mina, Arafat, Muzdalifa, and the Grand Mosque in Mecca. So indeed it is a happy day in which we could see there is not a single inch free here in the Prophet's Mosque, where believers are gathering inside of the mosque and also outside of the mosque in the marble yards, all of them waiting eagerly to listen to the beautiful out loud repetition of the remembrance of Allah, which we will listen to in about 3 minutes from now, and also to listen eagerly and sincerely to the sermon which will be delivered also right after the prayer, the Eid prayer, inshallah ta'ala. It is a happy day that we ask Allah to complete and perfect this happiness and this gratitude with the safe arrival of our fellow Muslim brothers and sisters who are now in Mina undertaking their Hajj. And also we ask Allah to accept from us all and to give us from his greatest rewards and to give us the best of his rewards. Allahumma ameen. I could see the happiness and pleasure and joy expressed by the fellow Muslims here in the Prophet's Mosque, and also amongst the callers to the Adhan Al-Mu'addinun, the Mu'addinin of the Prophet's Mosque. All of them are gathering here in a happy environment, in a peaceful environment, in a loving and caring environment. All of this environment indicates and expresses the unity amongst us Muslims, and also expresses how such happy occasions shall be lived and how such happy occasions shall be experienced. It is a great experience, and the scenes here in the Prophet's Mosque, where we come to you live by the Saudi Channel 2 and the Sunan Abuya Channel, the scenes themselves are indescribable. People are happy, people are grateful towards Allah, people praise Allah for His endless bounties and blessings. People are out loud repeating the remembrance of Allah by saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allah is great, Allah is great, there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. Allah is great, Allah is great, and praise be to Allah. All perfect praise be to Allah indeed for these blessings, for these bounties, where we could see the believers in the Prophet's Mosque are all of them gathering outside of the mosque also to listen to today's sermon, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah make us amongst those who benefit from what they listen to. Allahumma ameen. The inhabitants of the Medina, together with the guests of the merciful, together with the Muslim brothers and sisters who came from all the parts of the globe here to the Prophet's Mosque, here to this second holiest mosque for us Muslims to pray the Eid prayer and to attend this happy and great occasion, the Eidul Adha occasion in the Prophet's Mosque and in these holy lands. It is indeed a happy occasion, it is indeed a great pleasure and a great honor for us in the Saudi Channel to be with you in this live broadcast, and we look forward to being with you in more and more happy occasions in the future, inshallah ta'ala, by Allah's will. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allah is great, Allah is great, there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. Allah is great, Allah is great, and praise be to Allah. All perfect praise be indeed to Allah. Allahumma ameen. So now we will listen to the out loud repetition of the remembrance of Allah here from the Prophet's Mosque in Holy Medina. We will be with you live in the coverage of this, inshallah ta'ala.
Allah. سبحان الله بكرة واصيلا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر
Come on.
أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله
صلاة العيد أثابكم الله.
استووا اعتدلوا. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. لإيلاف قريش إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا الله أكبر الله أكبر. 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 الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا ولك الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الحمد لله وسبحان الله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه إلى يوم الدين الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد أما بعد فيا أيها الناس أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله جل وعلا وطاعته في السر والنجوى معاشر المسلمين إن الأمة الإسلامية تمر بفتن مدلهمة وإن رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصى الأمة بما يدرأ عنها الضرر ويخلصها من الشر ففي خطبة الوداع يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن دماءكم وأموالكم وأعراضكم حرام عليكم كحرمة يومكم هذا في شهركم هذا في بلدكم هذا ومن أعظم الفتن فتنة منهج الغلو في تكفير المسلمين دون إحكام للقواعد الشرعية الدقيقة فتنةٌ زلَّت فيها أقدامٌ وظلَّت بها أفهام قادت إلى عواقب وخيمةٍ ومفاسِد جمَّة قال جل وعلا ولا تقولوا لمن ألقى إليكم السلام لست مؤمناً تبتغون عرض الحياة الدنيا وفي صحيح البخاري أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ومن رمى مؤمناً بكفرٍ فهو كقتله يا أهل الإسلام إن مثل هذه المسائل المهمة الشائكة لا يجوز بأي حال أن يخوض فيها إلا العلماء الراسخون والأئمة المجتهدون ووفق تشاور جماعي بينهم لا اجتهاد فردي وفي محيط تحقيق مدقق وتأصيل متقن بعيد عن كل هوى وتعصب وبمن أن عن حماسة متدفقة وردة فعل بعاطفة جياشة لا تحكمها أصول المنهج العلمي المؤصل فبهذا المسلك بإذن الله تسلم الأمة من منهج الإفراط والغلو والتفريط وتسير إلى ما أراد الله لها من وحدة إسلامية ورابطة إيمانية تتحقق بها مصالح الدين والدنيا معا الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد يا شباب الإسلام أنتم زهرة الأمة اليانئة وثمرتها الباسقة فكونوا على دراية وكياسة وتيقنوا بأنه إن عدلتم عن هذا المسلك المرتضى فستبقى الأمة لقمة سائغة في أيادي الأعداء يحركون بينها الفتن عن طريق اجتهادات فردية خاطئة تحدث ورطات عظمى وشرور كبرى وهذا ما حذر منه صلى الله عليه وسلم في خطبة الوداع حين قال لا ترجعوا بعدي كفارا يضرب بعضكم رقاب بعض الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد ومن زاغ عن المحجة النبوية التي بيَّنها صلى الله عليه وسلم بقوله من صلى صلاتنا واستقبل قبلتنا وأكل ذبيحتنا فهو المسلم الذي له ذمة الله ورسوله، رواه البخاري. من زاغ عن ذلك جاء بأحكام جائرة في الأمة تؤول إلى مفاسد قد لا تستدرك آثارها. ولذا تواترت نصوص العلماء المحققين قديماً وحديثاً في التحذير من تكفير المعين إلا ببرهان شرعي أوضح من شمس النهار، ووفق منظومة توفر شروط وانتفاء موانع حماية لسياج إرض المسلم في دينه ونفسه وماله. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: أيما امرئ قال لأخيه يا كافر فقد باء بها أحدهما إن كان كما قال وإلا رجعت عليه. يقول الشوكاني: بعد تحذيره من الجرأة على تكفير لا إله إلا الله، فإن هذه جناية لا يعدلها جناية، وجراءة لا تماثلها جراءة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. معاشر المسلمين، احذروا من كل اجتهاد يفرق الأمة وهي في وقت تدعو الضرورة إلى الاصطفاف على الوحيين والاتحاد على البر والتقوى لمواجهة تحديات ضخمة، إن لم نكن حذرين فستأتي على أخضرها ويابسها. فعلى الجميع سلوك طريقة الصحابة الأتقياء، وأن يستلهموا الصلاح والفلاح من وصية نبيهم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في خطبة الوداع، حيث قال: وقد تركت فيكم ما إن تمسكتم به لن تضلوا بعده أبدا كتاب الله. والواجب أن تسري بيننا النصيحة الصادقة المخلصة والمحاورة الهادئة الجميلة المؤطرة بالأدب الرفيع والخلق الجميل، وفق المنهج النبوي الذي يقوم على معاني الإنصاف والعدل والرحمة والإحسان، وفي إطار الحجة والبرهان بالأصول العلمية المؤصلة، كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: الدين النصيحة، قالها ثلاثة. وفقنا الله جميعا للهدى والتقوى. أقول هذا القول وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب، فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. أحمد ربي وأشكره، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وأسأل الله جل وعلا أن يجعل أوقاتنا عامرةً بالمسرات والمسارعة إلى الخيرات. عباد الله، الأضحية عن النفس والأهل سنة نبوية وشعيرة عظيمة. روى ابن ماجه بسند حسن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من وجد سعة فلم يضحي فلا يقربن مصلانا. والمقصود الأعظم من الأضحية تحقيق التعظيم والإجلال لله جل وعلا، فعظموا خالقكم وأكثروا من ذكره وشكره. معاشر المسلمين، إن بلاد الحرمين شرفها الله بحمل أمانة خدمة الحرمين، وقد وفقها الله جل وعلا بحمل الأمانة خير قيام، فجعلت في أول اهتمامها وأقصى غاياتها ذلك. وإن إنكار ذلك مكابرة وسفسطة لا تكون إلا لمنكر للحواس المعلومة المشاهدة بالعيان التي يراها العالم كله، ونكران الجهود الخيرة تأباه النصوص الشرعية والطباع السوية. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يشكر الله من لا يشكر الناس. زاد الله هذه البلاد وزاد حكومتها هدىً وتوفيقاً وسداداً ونجاحاً وأمناً وأماناً وفلاحاً. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. إن من أعظم الأعمال الإكثار من الصلاة والسلام على النبي الكريم. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك وأنعِم على سيدنا ونبينا محمدٍ وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم اجعل أيامنا أيام سرور وحبور يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم وفقنا للعمل الصالح في هذه الأيام المباركة. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم فرج هموم المسلمين، اللهم اجعل أيامهم عامرة بالخير والهدى والتقى يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم أنزل عليهم أمنك، اللهم أنزل عليهم الأمن والصلاح والفلاح يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم وفق ولي أمرنا ونائبيه لما تحب وترضى. اللهم وفقهم ووفق جميع أمراء هذه البلاد لما فيه خدمة الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.